Sunday, Sunday!
Or whatever day you happen to be watching this,
Halo Derby is proud to introduce the Ultimate Bunk Room!
And by the way, if you're looking for something to make into an office, there are very few trailers better suited to it than this one.
Little too much, maybe? A little too much off the top. Hi, I'm Josh the RV Nerd. Welcome to Halo RV. Behind us, I do feel, is a camper that you could argue has an ultimate bunk room. This is the 31KQBTSXYZ LMNOP Wildwood here at Halo RV. And it has not quite that long of a model number, but it does have a pretty big designator. Every one of those letters means something. It's got about a 31-foot walkable space. It has a K outside kitchen, Q quad bunk, and then TS triple slide. The thing on this camper, though, is it's like it's almost like two campers. It's almost like two in one, because the rear room on this has opposing 3 foot deep, like full depth floor flush slides. It's a triple rack and pinion mega slide system, where the rear room is as large basically as the living room, which is really crazy cool. This model has been very popular among like traveling military families or homeschoolers, because not only does it have a giant room back there, we're on a drizzly, crappy, freezing, rainy day like this, you could be like, kids, you're driving me nuts, go to your room. But you could like hold class back there and wait till you, a lot of the Wildwood stuff, people said, man, they really look, they rehashed the 21s. Don't get me wrong, it's not like they did a total facelift, but check out the updates back here on this one.
Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is just give you a quick lay of the land here, because the thing is, like, you've seen this living room before. If you've been shopping, a super slide bunkhouse has this living room or something really darn close to it. Like, you got a U-dinette, you got a sofa over there, and we're going to come back and re-look at all of this and, you know, check out all the kitchen space and all that stuff real quick as long as I'm here. I am just going to give you the point of view, like, if you sit down at the sofa, this is kind of what you're going to see right here. I will offer real quick, I wish that entry door had a window. I suppose, you know, when it's summertime, if it's not too scorching, you can always peek outside via the screen door, and there's always that large breeze viewing window right there for the kitchen. But I do wish it had a window in the entry door, but neither here nor there. I don't suspect that's going to change anytime soon. What I want to do, instead of spending a bunch of time here in the living room and working our way back, to me, the biggest, most important, impressive factor of this camper right here is this rear opposing deep slide bunk room. And this thing is awesome. This gives us all that space where if you're doing more than just casual camping, or if you got a big freaking family, and which is a technical term, by the way, a BFF. that stands for more than best friends forever. You know, you need all that extra space. That's where this is going to come in handy. Now, that door over here is kind of in the way, but it also highlights the point that we have a door. And the thing is, if you're looking at this, it's as much of a bunk room as it is like a bedroom for the kids, or a craft room, or again, we're gonna get to see some office, office function. Anyway, sorry, apparently I'm tongue-tied today. Office function, you get the idea. Second living room entertainment, where on a rainy day you could have, like, this is a model I could see people not towing. This is a model I can see people using almost like a destination trailer, where you just get it somewhere and you park it and you never bother towing it again. Like, this is that summertime almost retreat cottage getaway, you know? Now, over here, there's kind of just like a little daytime bench. There's a little bit of shoe storage below it, but you might notice there's that extra like bunk pad up top there. Well, that actually is the bunk mattress for the lower bed that we have down here. Because this RV has a big camp kitchen built right into the slide out face, they had to come up with a more creative solution like that to maintain the quad bunk functionality of this thing. But over here in the opposing slide, you've got a flip down bunk with a 60 by 80 Versa Queen below. But what is awesome about that is, like I said, if what you're looking for is office function, it completely removes. The VersaQueen doesn't require hammers, nuts, bolts, staples, screws, or any other known fastener here. Not even, you know, double-sided sticky tape. You can totally get all of that stuff out of the way. But again, we have the ability to convert this into like extra living space. And that bed mattress basically folds in half. And it's not impressive maybe on camera. I'm telling you, come in one of these and sit on that. It doesn't suck, frankly. I think it might actually be a little bit better than the couch in the living room. And I'm not joshing. I'm just Josh. That's so stupid. Sorry. You may have also caught how both next to both slides, there's a set of USB plugs there to be able to, you know, keep some phones charged up or something like that. And in case you're wondering what this black thing is right here, that's another new for 22 feature Wildwood's putting in a lot of their models. That is actually a blackboard, a chalkboard that you can use here. Now, this RV, it's normally 30 amp service. You can build it with 50 amp service, like I think we've actually done here. I believe that vent up there is the second air prepped vent. I'd have to do some looking around to verify that. I don't think it's the one in the bedroom. I think it is the one back here. But look at, did you see the ridiculous amount of storage in this thing? Look at all those handy dandy little cube organizers. You've got four more of those under the master bed that we haven't even seen yet. But now that I'm looking at this, and again, I try to be fair. One of the things I don't know that I personally agree with is I don't know that I like how the converter box and panel is back here, potentially locked behind two slide outs and in the bunk room where the kids are going to be able to get to it. Personally, I don't like that. Personally, I would rather that was somewhere else. Is that a deal breaker for you, or is that just a kind of thing? Let me know in the comments. Kind of tell me what you're thinking about right there. Now, back to the living room. First things first, up top here, standard, this RV would have a 13,500 BTU air conditioner, a big triple slide like this. Personally, I think a dealership, I think, would be stupid for not putting a 15,000 BTU air on it. Unless there was some kind of mistake or something, I just can't imagine anyone doing anything other than that. Interesting thing here, new for 22, they have put dimmer lighting on your main cabin lights, and they have positional memory, which is actually kind of cool. They'll remember where their up and down position was last left, and you can stop it anyway through that high or low swell, by the way. And that's not daylight coming through the top of the slide, although that'd be a real big issue. That would certainly garner some attention. They're using white accent lighting instead of blue accent lighting. Hallelujah! Like, I wish more manufacturers would take note from that. Now, earlier, I said, hey, look at this. It's just another U-dinette and a sofa beside it. But I might have been doing a little tricksy on you. Because that is only one of the several functions that you can get here out of the Wildwood Versa Lounge. Kind of like we have the Versa Bunk. What it makes for is an RV that is, well, versatile, crocodile. So stupid. Versatile crocodile, the RV mascot we always knew we never wanted. Anyway, the point I'm making is you can do just about anything you want with this. You can make it a giant super lounge like we saw. You can make it a the lounge that we're looking at here with almost sort of like a desk. You can make it a U-dinette. You can make it a traditional seating situation. There's not a whole lot of limitations that you have on this. And since that back basically can be completely removed, like we saw, one of the other cool things about this is you can also convert this into one big giant super slide, super sleeper, complete with blackout roller shades. And what's also very cool about this is on the back side of those, they actually have a white backer so that if the sun is just screaming, you're reflecting that solar radiation instead of absorbing it. But we're also still not done with the Versa Lounge, because it includes three of these food safe stackable totes down here under the sofa section. And then over here under the dinette section, yep, you guessed it, mole storage, which always reminds me of Monty Python and the Holy Grail. They're like, And what else burns besides witches? More witches! Oh, I love that movie. I could watch it every single day of my life. Over here, interesting that Wildwood was really, they were one of the first to standardize the larger 12-volt DC compressor fridges. What's interesting about that, because I said the word interesting, is you can still option a two-way gas electric refrigerator. But the reason that's interesting is because you swap down to only a 6-cubic-foot gas electric fridge. So if you're going to do some boondock and you want to add some solar, first of all, I'm just gonna say this. I don't think this is a great option for boondockers. I hope the people at Wildwood aren't offended by that. That's just my personal opinion. One of the reasons I say that is because I don't think it's really built with boondockers in mind. And I think one of the best examples of that is the fact that, first of all, we have a 12-volt fridge with no factory standard solar package. But secondly, the holding tank capacities are not, I think, suitable for a lot of boondocking. And I do not mean the pun as I say this, but oh crap, I forgot to look at the bathroom. Probably because I'm out of my normal order and rotation of things. And it's a tiny thing, but I love the little slat work at the bottom of the storage right there in the new 22 series. The, you know, space around the toilet in this might be restrictive if you're a fluffier person. At my size, I have enough room to take care of the butt napkins as required. But, you know, some people, you might have trouble in here. By the way, these are all sealed edge press membrane counters. I love the panel print on that wall right there. And you'll only find that in the bathroom. It just kind of changes things up. But remember, that taller ceiling means headroom in the shower. So if you're 6'3", 6'4", or shorter, you're going to stand in that shower, I think, probably just fine. And this is not a radius shower. This is one of the handy-dandy rectangular showers, which tend to give people a little bit extra room. And did you notice, you also have the radius bar at the top of that shower right there, giving us the extra elbow room where we need it. And then, moving our way on up here. We've got the electric space heat and Tootsie Toaster over there. With the new for 22 feature, we've got the handy little accent light down below the wide open giant shoe garage. And notice too, if you are worried about the entertainment focus on this, because for the most part, yes, absolutely. That's a 90-degree neckbreaker entertainment wall. But I don't know that this is a camper made like for sitting inside and watching TV all the day. At the same time, though, when it's in Versa Lounge mode, you can absolutely have, like, whether you're sitting over here at the half dinette, half desk kind of thing, it's actually not bad. If we move our way over here to sit at the Versa Lounge, it's not bad. And how about the fact that, you know, an adult-sized person could set a pillow down here, stretch out on this thing while the kids go to bed, and you can actually enjoy some decent daytime entertainment. Not too bad. So, it's a rainy day. Kids are in the bunk room. What are you watching? Let me know. moving forward here, we have a swing-in privacy door for the master bedroom. And like I said, we are not done with the storage. And I mentioned how we had four more of those handy little things. Like, this is basically acting like a dresser, I think, in the bedroom area here. And that over there, another new for 22 thing, it has a small but a built-in laundry hamper. Anything's better than nothing, right? Notice, too, that this is access to the entire front pass-through compartment. So if some cargo shifts and you're having trouble getting to it, you don't have to, like, belly crawl in there or send one of the kids in after it. Which I'm just saying I got drug out of a pass-through more than once to pull out my parents' hitch. Now, a couple other things here for you. Wildwood does use a Camp Queen. It's a 60 by 74 bed. But when they went to that radius front nose away from their old like flat front nose, they didn't realize it, but they actually sucked the bed forward in the radius nose of the camper and accidentally, thankfully, created a ton of room for a true queen in here. If you want to upgrade your bed, you can do that. Notice, too, how even though we've left the living room, we're still getting the nice roller shades. You don't always get those in a lot of campers. A lot of, especially stick and tin trailers, ladies and gentlemen. And you're, please verify this on your own. I think you'll be very quickly surprised by, oh, I never really realized that. A lot of people, when they're looking at details like that, they only shop the living room. but you're buying and using the whole RV, right? So that's why I want to give you those extra details, like the fact that that tall window also opens for air. And both sides of the bed have the Wildwood hidden CPAP storage pockets, household and USB plugs, but it doesn't have to be just for CPAP users. You want to charge a phone in there out of the way, or just, you know, just keep a personal object out of, you know, daily easy reach grab space, but you want to be able to, you know, get to it when you need it. Those little access panels are very handy. Now, for what it's worth, just a little look at here with the lights off. I don't know what you're exactly going to glean from this. I just thought I'd showcase it while I was looking at it. And, of course, closing up the slides for Road Mode. Now, normally on something like this, the message that I have for you is that for Road Mode, we're snacktastic. We can get in here. We can get around the countertop. We can get to the refrigerator and enough of the cabinetry that you could stop and feed your family at least some quick sandwiches or chips or something like that. But at that point, this is where I look up and I say, but you can't get to the bunk room or the bathroom. But here's kind of the thing I've learned from some of our viewers. If you leave the bathroom door open and then close the slide out, I'm not saying it's super convenient. You're definitely going to want to get this table out of the way. Technically, you should be traveling with the table down, by the way, not what I've done here. This is just for quick demo purposes. You can actually get to the bathroom in transit if you're willing to do a little bit of a Luke knee walker maneuver. And understand, I am also, I should really advise you, you want to spend as little time walking and climbing in that slide out as possible. And if you're going to be doing it, you actually want to do it on the outside edge of the slide where there's the greatest amount of support, not over here on the inside edge as much as you can possibly help it. Now, keep in mind, if you choose to do that, please get something like some really aggressive door stops to make sure that door isn't jiggle banging all over the place. And potentially, and I didn't test this, maybe I'll test this out next time, or if anybody owns this floor plan, can you confirm for me, could you do the same thing where if you have a small kid, could you leave the bunk room door open? Although with the double opposing slides back there, I don't think you're going to get, I think the bunk room's a total loss. Forget that. But we can kind of, sort of, oh my gosh, it's an emergency, I'm going to pee my pants, get to the bathroom if we absolutely have to. Hope this helps some people. Now, before we get too far along here, let's talk towing. I mean, look at the size of this behemoth. And it's like 8,700 pounds and change dry weight before cargo. I do not feel this is a good pairing for a half ton vehicle. I do think because of its weight, length, size, etc., this is best handled by a 3/4 ton and above. Opinions may vary on that. And anyone who owns this floor plan or something very similar like it, please feel free to chime in and say, you know, here's what I have. And here's what I used to tow it with, because this is a theory that I have, and real world experience, I think, trumps anything some stupid guy with a camera says. Anyway, I trust you folks who actually own these more than I trust myself. One of the nice things about all that length, though, is even with that big door side slide back in the bunk room and the camp kitchen that we'll get to, plenty of room out here for some nice awning space. Now, the front of these is a nice smooth aluminum sweep. And if you're really looking at this, other than that decal on the nose, or as my Canadian friends refer to them, the decals, by the way. Overall exterior of this is basically paint. You know, people spend on big fifth wheels and toy haulers all kinds of crazy money for paint, and that's basically what's standard on a stick and tin trailer. I think it's a very undervalued asset of them. They don't get the credit they deserve for that. The entire nose being smooth, it's a thicker aluminum, by the way, so the whole nose is basically stone guard. There's a battery disconnect up front, so the power tongue jack isn't dead when you go to hook up to it. Although, remember, this is now solar prep, so if you want to leave a solar battery tender on this, not a bad thing to do. Power tongue jack on the front right there. And this is available, and today you're actually getting to see this RV with the optional power corner stabilizer jack package, which is why there's nothing on this bracket over here. That's normally where the manual jack would be located with the JT strong arm stabilizers. Now, I'm very curious about something, and if anybody could chime in and help me on this, because I'm really not able to find any clarity on it right now. Wildwood's own build sheet says that the power jack's upgrade is supposed to include the JT strong arm stabilizers. What up, Wildwood? Why am I not seeing these things? I mean, I know I'm not the brightest bulb in the crayon box, but I know what a JT strong arm stabilizer looks like, and I don't see them. Anyway, over here, we do have magnet holdbacks for our baggage doors, which is awful darn handy. Now, it is a full pass-through,
That being said, they don't use the same size baggage door on both sides of the pass-through. But at the same time, I don't think this is like too small where it's prohibitive and stopping me from getting in there. But from the other side, you actually get a much bigger perspective of just how large that entire kind of pass-through compartment is right there, and kind of seeing those doors as comparative size. Notice too, this is one of the new for 22 updates on the Wildwoods. Over here on the door side, they turn that into a dry erase board, which, how would you use that? The only thing I've really kind of thought of, because it's sort of like too high to just set my kid up and with a dry erase marker and let her scribble the day away when she was a little kid, would draw all day, you know? But if we're sitting here playing like bag toss or something like that, or a yard game, maybe then that could work for us. Once again, good size power awning on this guy. And that is an anti-slam door, although, again, I personally dislike the lack of any kind of window in it. I would at least like a frosty glass cover on that just to kind of let some light through. That's just my personal two cents, but everyone has their own opinion on that. I really do like, though, if we're going to have outside speakers on a camper, I like it when they're low, not really high, because when they're all the way up there by the awning, the only people that get a good listen to your freedom rock, brother, are the neighbors. And I don't know why, they always have the worst taste in music, because when I listen to freedom rock with high-mounted outside speakers, so do my neighbors. But back here, right on the face of this slide, you've got that a big camp kitchen. And what really impresses me is they didn't just throw a fridge in here and an open space and go, yep, it's a camp kitchen. It's actually a fully featured, it's a fully operational Death Star. We've got the storage on top. We've got the storage on the right with those cute, cool little organizer totes that are handy. We've got a good-sized fridge, TV hookups, but a real sink with a real drain into a holding tank and some counter space. And it's all mounted low enough that, like, as an adult, this is roughly at my waist level. It'd probably be mid-stomach on my wife. But it's functional. A little kid could actually, you could be like, hey, you know, I could tell my daughter, hey, go wash your hands. And she can actually reach and use this thing. Whereas so many outside camp kitchens, the sink is mounted up so high that it's just not even functional. Now I spotted something as I was opening the fridge on this one. And I'm really wondering, like, what would you do over here? There's like coat hooks hidden over here in this little pocket. Now, kudos to Wildwood for not wasting that space, although I do see a little blemish on the wood fascia there that obviously we're going to have to take care of before somebody buys this one. But, and I hope you appreciate, by the way, that I'm not blind to that stuff. I acknowledge it. I try to be very real world about this. Anyway, like a dog leash or like a place to hang tongs or something, because this does come with its own outside grill. Now, I actually... If you were to try to use this grill as it's currently positioned, you'd actually have to be standing inside of that arm. I just have this kind of here as demonstrative so that you can see it's a big double swing arm. You can swing that thing all the way around, but it stays on the bumper. And I think that's part of the reason the outside camp kitchen on this thing rocks my socks off with that extra counter space, because they didn't have to like bury a cooker in it. And yes, of course, you have a propane cooker hooker. It is still technically, by the way, a propane cooker hooker because it comes off the side. It is not yet a propanus. It is close to the gas coming off the backside, but that is not technically what's happening here. I believe spare tires are actually still optional on these. I have a hard time remembering that because it's absolutely not a question. Every single trailer that rolls in here needs to have a spare tire in one way, shape, or form. We're backup camera ready. The roof, it is not on fire, thankfully, but it is walkable. The RV is ladder prepped, although it does not include an option from the factory for a ladder. It is slide awning prepped. It is solar prepped. Those kind of things are on here, so kind of keep that in mind. We are right next to the road, by the way, so apologies for the background noise. Now, a couple things down here for you. It is weird to me. It must have been just not close enough to cross pipe the way that all these valves hook up, because it just doesn't all connect right here. And actually what's interesting is I think the front one is the kitchen and the bathroom gray and black. And I think this back one is just the outside camp kitchen, which is actually making me wonder, does that actually go into a holding tank? It goes through the enclosed, heated, protected accessibility. So I think it has a holding tank, but folks, I might need to verify that before I get too far along here. So apologies if I have accidentally misstated something there. And oh, look at that. We are like right between two major stores like Walmart's, and their garbage blows into our driveway all the time. I'll have to climb under there and get whatever that thing is between the tires. I hate having garbage flying around our dealership. So if you haven't done so, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our videos to catch the next one. And let me know what you think about this trailer. Good, bad, ugly, otherwise. What do you like? What would you change? I've shared my opinion, and I'd love to hear yours. Or is there something that we're doing good here that we should know about so we keep doing it? Or is there something I can do better for you? I'll leave you a link in the video description to check for pricing and availability anytime. And as always, when you're ready, we're ready. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and stay warm and dry, everyone. This sucks out here.